Welcome to the ninth stage of the 12th annual tour of Qinghai Lake. We have got beautiful weather here for the Peak Zhangye circuit race. We're going to have 14 corners, we're going to have 125 racers, and we're going to have some fast times. Big crowds are here ready to watch, and we've got a little bit of action coming up already because everybody's getting their big gear bikes out for the flatness, the fastness, and the full-on speed. One person who's intimately familiar with all of the bicycles and bicycle racing, as well as the Tour of Qinghai Lake, is Martin Brun.
I've been here four times, and I must say the organization is very high standard.
Great.
Very high standard, yes.
Super. Have you been seeing improvement over the few years?
Yes, I have. Yes, oh yes. In particular in relation to the food.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. No, I'm not joking. I mean, in the beginning, this was, of course, purely Chinese food. And of course, the European teams were not used to it.
Mm-hmm.
So, but this has really, really been improved. And this year, it's without any complaint from nobody. Nobody had any complaint about this. No, very good.
The Peak Zhangye circuit race is going to be quite the experience. This is not your standard 90-degree corners. This is 117 kilometers, 5 laps of a 23.3 circuit. We're starting off down where we finished just the other day before the rest day. And from there, we're going to head out 14 corners, going through a beautiful wetland park with unfortunately a headwind, and then from there we're going to wind our way back through the town of Zhangye and head back to the finish. There's a 90 degree corner right before the finish line and 400 meters of straight flat road for the sprinters. All the racers are quite happy to be down from high altitude. They're no longer up at 3,000 meters for an average, and right now they're starting out at 1,500. Everybody slowly rolls away from the line. Everybody's warmed up nevertheless, but things get hot fast. Even with winds, even with tailwinds, even with crowds screaming their names, the peloton is going to be cruising along at 53 kilometers an hour at an average for the first hour. At the bell, we had one lap to go for our first sprint of two in the day. The racers have got their lines picked out, and everybody is pulling for their own. One of the competitions that has not yet been decided happens to be for the Green Points jersey. We've got Sacha Modolo, he's in first place, but in second place, just 15 points behind, happens to be Max Ricchisi. Both of those guys have got their lead out men online. They're looking for their lead out men and they're getting ready to head up into sprint number one out of two. There's 5 points separating them. Let's see who's going to get the first one. Yes! I think it's going to be Sacha Modolo taking the first sprint points for 5 points. And yes, it is. Sacha takes it easily right over Marco Colliadon. Two riders from down under on Team Australia are out in front with Liu Biao, who has been non-stop attacking for the last 4 days, as well as Yang Zhentao. So we've got two Chinese locals and two Australians trying to make a breakaway. As hard as they worked, they could only get 33 seconds. The peloton ended up chasing them down with one lap to go. Sprint two was won by Marco Benfato from Continental Astana, and Sonny Calabreri got second, and Mauro Finetti took in third. Now, things are heating up. We've already got the pace strung out. They were doing 60 kilometers an hour that last lap. On the final straightaway on South Ring Road, we have Lamprey Merida, we've got United Healthcare, we've got all the big trains being pulled up to the front, and they've got their sprinters right in tow. Down towards the finish line they're heading, and it looks like we've got green jerseys in front, and yes, it is, it's Sacha Modolo, he's taking off from the front, but yet, coming off to the left-hand side, we do see some blue jerseys coming up the blue train, and it's Modolo taking it over Jake Keogh. Maximiliano Ricchesi also took third place. He's been on the podium a lot lately, but never been on the top step. So the stage results look like this. I only had one teammate with me, and so I was having to make use of the other teams. They took me pretty close to the last corner, and then with 500 meters to go, my teammate ended up getting me in the perfect position so that I could go from 300 meters and get to the finish again, first place. So my teammates are the ones doing the work for me. Once again, on the top step of the podium, we don't have girls in blue, we have Sacha Modolo. yet another bouquet, yet another bottle of champagne, and an incredibly cute mascot. Everybody is enthusiastic today, blasting the champagne everywhere. Still leading the best Asian category, we've got Samad Pustadiye. He is still in there. I think this is day number 5 for him. Also, leading in the King of the Mountains with one small climb left tomorrow, we still have Samad in first place. Green Jersey is pretty firmly on the shoulders of Sacha Modolo, at least for today, because we still have 4 stages to go, and we still have other good sprinters in the race. Samad Pustadiye is still in the yellow jersey, but number 2 is Yevgeny Nipponyeshyi. He is in second place. Daniil Formykin is third. This is still a fairly close race because we have time bonuses coming up in the next 4 stages, and the top 6 are within 1 minute 40 seconds. Tomorrow we're heading from Uwei to Jingtai, 191 kilometers and a couple climbs. It's going to be a hot one, and it's going to be fun to watch. I'm Sean Nagel for Cycling CN. We'll see you tomorrow.